In this example, we have a liquid phase reaction, A goes to B, and it's in an adiabatic batch reactor, and then we're given various parameters for the system. And the question is, what's the reactor temperature when the conversion of A reaches 60%? So really all we're dealing with here is the energy balance. The heat of reaction is independent of temperature, which also means the heat capacity of A is the same as the heat capacity of B. There's a linear relation between how much reacts and how much the temperature changes. And so the energy balance then is just that we have so many moles of A initially in the system. Well, at a later time, we have Na plus Nb, and that's going to be just equal to Na0. We start out with just A in the reactor. Though if there was also B, it would not change the answer. We would just say Na plus Nb is Na0 plus Nb0. So Na times the heat capacity of A, a molar heat capacity, times the temperature change, whereas all the heat of reaction is going to heat up the reactor contents, so T is our final temperature, T0 is our starting temperature of 100 degrees. This is rate of reaction times the number of moles of B that's formed. Rate of reaction is how much heat energy change for each mole B that's formed. Now I can rearrange this equation and write it in terms of concentrations. Number of moles initially is the reactor volume times initial concentration. And the number of moles of B finally would be the concentration of B times the volume. The concentration of B is going to be, if we have in this system that 60% reacts, then the concentration of B is 60% of the initial concentration of A. So the volume cancels, concentration cancels, and we end up with an equation that T minus T0 is just minus the heat of reaction times 0.6 over the heat capacity of A. And the heat of reaction, we'll put it in joules per mole. It's negative, and I have a negative sign here, so this becomes positive times 0.6. Heat capacity is 83.6 joules per mole Kelvin. The final temperature then in the reactor is 205 degrees C. This problem gives us a reaction mechanism with two steps. A plus B goes to C, and then A plus C reacts to D. An important aspect here is that C is reactive intermediate. So that means we want to develop a rate expression that would have concentrations of A and B, but not C. In general, it would also have concentrations of D, but we're saying let's simplify it where the concentration D is insignificant. What we can do is apply the steady state approximation to the species C. We can say that the rate formation of C is zero. Namely, we reach a constant C concentration during reaction. It's not changing with time. Well, we have the first reaction. Since they're elementary steps, we can write it as concentration of A and a concentration of B. We then have the reverse, and I'll use rate constant 2 for this second step, concentration of C's. 1 is forward, 2 is reverse, and then 3 is for the next reaction. And C is reacting in the second reaction, also second order. We can rearrange and solve this equation for the concentration of C. So now we have the concentration of reactive intermediate, the overall rate of reaction, which would be the rate that we're forming, D, would be K3, the concentration of A, the concentration of C. So this is K1, K3, so it's second order in the numerator, and then it also has the concentration of reactant in the denominator. So this is the rate expression we're interested in. We don't have the reverse reaction of D going back to A plus C just because the concentration of D is low. This example We have an isothermal plug flow reactor, and we're using for the gas phase reaction, A plus B goes to C, so we have a mole change. And we're not going to solve to get a numerical answer. We want to write down the equations that if we substitute into a program that solves differential equations, we can determine how much of A has reacted the conversion. And so we're feeding a 70-30 mixture of A and B. We're given the overall flow rate, the pressure, and the temperature coming in. So we have volumetric flow rate coming in. The volumetric flow rate leaving is going to be different. It's isothermal, so the temperature is the same. We're given the volume, so volume equals zero, volume equals 50 liters. And what we're going to do is write down mass balances, and the easiest way is to write mass balances for A and B. And now we'll need initial conditions. At V equals zero, we're going to need FA zero, which is 0.7 of F total zero, and FB zero, which is 0.3 of F total zero. So we have to calculate F total coming into the reactor. And we use the ideal gas law to determine this: pressure times volumetric flow rate over the gas constant and absolute temperature. So we have the total flow rate coming in. We can get a numerical value for this that allows us to determine FA0 and FB0, our initial conditions. We need the concentrations. So the concentration, of course, changes with time for two reasons: because of reaction, because of the mole change. And so the concentration of A is the molar flow rate of A over the volumetric flow rate, and likewise concentration of B. Well, the differential equations are calculating the molar flow rates of A and B as we move along the reactor. So what we need is an equation for the volumetric flow rate, which would be the total molar flow rate times RT over P. So this is FA plus FB plus our product FC times RT over P. Well, how do we get FC? There's several ways, but the easiest is just to write a differential equation for FC as K times concentration of A, where this is a plus sign. And of course, we need initial conditions that FC is equal to zero initially. So we're almost finished. We need to put in a program the rate constant. We also need to put in the program the pressure. Let's substitute in this equation the gas constant 0.0831 in these units, the temperature 475, and the last thing we need is telling it when to stop. So the final volume 50, it starts at V equals zero. Calculate conversion. So if the problem is asking what is the conversion, we could certainly calculate that also in the program, which is FA0 minus FA over FA0. We can't use concentrations to calculate conversion because of the mole change. And so we have then this series of equations here, plus the equations here. We need all these equations then substitute into a program to calculate the conversion of our reactant A.